So my name is Marianne van Boekhoven. I'm, as was already mentioned, an assistant professor at the Erasmus School of Health Policy and Management. So you might wonder, what does this have to do with the expats? Well, in my previous career, I was a PhD student in the sociology department. And my PhD thesis was about the local and cross-border ties of highly skilled migrants in Rotterdam and The Hague. And I wrote this book about that. And nowadays I'm studying health policy and still also diversity issues within health policy and also migrants working in healthcare. But now I will talk about my PhD. Two stereotypical images of expats that are found in academic literature. And these are that expats are like cosmopolitans who feel that the world is their home and they feel at home everywhere, and they like encountering differences and like to travel, and they don't have really their roots somewhere, but they feel at home everywhere. That's how it's presented in the literature. And the other image is that expats are like organization men and women who primarily identify with their organization or as an expat. And also, I did see in my research that people said, "I feel like an expat," but it was not the largest category that that we found. So I was a bit surprised by this, and I further studied what reasons people gave for saying that they are in one category or another. Well, this is just my personal interest also in this issue, because my grandparents were also expats in Curaçao. My grandfather worked for Shell there, and they were actually living in an expat bubble. So I think that you could classify this, and this is what also can be found in the literature, and it happened back then as well. So they lived in a really white community. The church was white. The school where my mother went was also only filled with Dutch white children. So this is really the typical image of the expat bubble. But now I want to show you some examples of the findings of my research in which did not match these stereotypical images. So this is the first one is that people who I interviewed were not cosmopolitans who said, "I feel at home everywhere." So this is a quote from a woman from the UK, and she says, "It's really a nice experience to be here, but I like to be with my friends and family. It's kind of difficult to feel that this is your real home. Also, it has to do with language, which is my fault, but the cultures are just different." So instead of celebrating these differences, she says that these differences make it really difficult to feel at home here. So she didn't really see herself as a cosmopolitan. And the second stereotypical image of people enjoying their life in the expat bubble, well, I found that many people do live in a kind of an expat bubble. Their friends are mainly from the same country or the same organization that they work for, but they are not really enjoying this very much, all of them. But many of them said that they actually prefer to also have more mixed contacts and to have Dutch friends. So some of them said, "Well, it's not that we prefer an expat bubble, it is there is a Dutch bubble and it's very difficult to enter the Dutch bubble." So they said, the Dutch stay too much in their own communities. So instead of the expats staying too much in their community, it are the Dutch who stay in their communities too much. And people said, and that was also often heard, I also spoke with more traditional migrant groups in the Netherlands, the Turkish, Moroccan, Surinamese migrants, and they said the same thing, that the Netherlands is kind of a closed society. So if you are a white ethnic Dutch, it's very easy to feel at home here, but if you have a different background, although we might say that we are inclusive society, that it's actually not so much the case that all people are so welcoming for migrants. So I would like to, this was also one of my conclusions, that to, apart from these stereotypical images, to introduce a third image, and that's the expat as a local citizen who faces some of the similar problems that other migrants face. And this is an example of a quote a person said, that she likes to live here, and she also put some effort into learning the language, and that it's, yeah, it takes some energy to integrate somewhere. And she doesn't only want to put energy in it, but she wants also something in return. So she felt that she she should live here a bit longer to integrate and to really feel at home here. And that also was a reason for her to not wanting to move from one country to another. And that this also limited her mobility a bit. She wanted to stay at one place and get to know the place and really integrate here. So that was for me a big surprise, because I thought expats are people who are moving from one place to another and do not really seek such local bonding. But my research showed that they actually do. Find that important. So this is the alternative view on expats. And I was also asked to conclude with a question. And my question was, what can the Dutch do? So the Dutch is also, of course, it's also a very diverse group. But what can they do to make expats feel more at home? Because often we might think, what should the expats do themselves to make this their home? But I think it's it must come from two ways. So I would be very interested to hear from internationals what they think the Dutch should do differently to make it more easy to integrate here. So that's my introduction. It's a bit more than 5 minutes, I think.
Thank you. Then we have Jacob Bedemeyer. Formerly, he was working as a lawyer, specialized in asylum and immigration law, right? But he succeeded Bianca van Kaathof as the alderman of Active City Diversity and Permits in 2016. You can probably better introduce yourself.
Well, that's true. I think I've been an immigration lawyer for 17 years, I think. So I experienced personally the introduction of the highly skilled migrant program here in Holland, because the Dutch economy wanted and needed new expats to support, because the Dutch, even the Europeans, could not provide sufficient highly skilled migrants. So that was a very new thing for us, because the immigration law in Holland is mostly a no unless, and it means you're not allowed to enter Holland unless you have a very specific reason to do so.
So that's also not my position in this, that I think people should do more this or that, but mainly what people told me, that they would prefer to be more part of this community that was mainly the cultural community in the Netherlands, and that was failing for them. And so it didn't meet their expectations, and that's also agree with the alderman, that it's really a lot about expectations. If you come here for half a year and you don't have any expectations of this local integration, or however you call it, incorporation or embeddedness, then it's not a problem. But if you want to stay here longer and you really have higher expectations, then it can be really disappointing staying here.
You might think it's one category of Dutch people, but if you are inside the Dutch bubble like me, you can diverse between, because there is, for example, a major difference between the people in the Randstad in Holland and the other parts of Holland, also culturally and even politically. You see already differences. You have differences between highly skilled and lowly skilled migrants. So we should also try to make the connection. If you are highly skilled migrants, you can maybe connect easier with highly skilled Dutch. If you're a lower skilled migrant, you can easier connect with lower skilled Dutch. So, but what I also wanted to say is, don't wait for the Dutch, because they will not come to you. You have to come to them. Do voluntary work. If you're single, date with the Dutch.
Really?
Yes.